With release 2305, we enable a new planning experience in Planner Workspaces. Follow me and I will show you what's to come. In this sample Planner Workspace, you see two components. One analytic chart that displays the planned profit on a map, and next to it there's a planning view which displays the related details. Hey, wait, what is going on? Oh, I see, there is a new version of Planner Workspace. The first interesting aspect is that I can display the chart on top and the planning view below. Seems like there is a new layout. But what else? On the left-hand side, there is a new navigation menu. The navigation menu provides you quick access to workbook variants or custom alerts. The menu enables users to efficiently navigate through the planning data that really matters. A workbook is a collection of one or more Planner Workspace components, such as planning views or analytic charts. It's possible to assign multiple workbooks to a workspace. Hence, you can navigate across different planning processes. Workbook variants are a set of filters that can be applied to the components of a workbook to display the relevant data. Planning filters can be assigned to variants as well. As you can see, you can define multiple variants per workbook. And there's also an alert tab. Wait for it, we will come to this later on. The next thing that has changed is that the workspace filter is now called workbook filter. You can use this filter area to apply filters to all displayed components. Below the workbook filter, you can see the actual workbook. In this case, there is a chart and a planning view assigned to the workbook. You can define your workbooks in the design mode. In the upper sections, there's no drastic change. However, the version scenario selection is now available in this area. Now that we've familiarized ourselves with the new concepts, we can interact with the workspace. At first, you can see the selected workbook variant. In case you need the complete screen size, you can hide the navigation menu by double-clicking the splitter. You can also see the filters defined for this variant. In this case, I made use of a planning filter. As usual, we can interact with the analytic chart. Here you can see the planned profit for the two customers in Germany. Based on the size of the bubble, I can see that the planned profit is not very high for those two customers. As a next step, let's open another workbook. You see how easy it is to display data from different planning processes in one single workspace. Here I could review the planned demand and the statistical forecast, but there's something else to highlight. Once you open the Alerts tab, you will notice the powerful integration of custom alerts. On the first level, you can review the alert subscriptions and the related number of alerts. After selecting an alert subscription, you see the alert details. In this example, we compare the statistical forecast against the planned customer demand. The forecast can be used to review the numbers once again. As I select the alert, the assigned workbook, meaning components that help me to understand and solve the alert, will be loaded. In addition to that, the context of the alert will be passed, so I only see the data that matters for that alert. The alert highlighting helps me to see the affected numbers right away. The other highlighted cells remains unchanged, but I want to snooze the alert so I'm not confronted with the same alert again. There are a lot of enhancements made in release 2305. For instance, there is a better support of planning filters. Next, there are more options to adjust the analytic charts right away from Planner Workspace. In release 2305, there's a new feature called job definitions. You can use job definitions to simplify job scheduling for planners when they use Planner Workspace. In case you want to collaborate with others on the same objects, you can now share them with write access. The new workbook variant concept also brings the whole sharing capability to the next level. But there's even more to discover. You want to get started? Try it on your own. In case you need more information, please visit the SAP Help Portal.